Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in the previous section we have studied what is an aerofoil. We have seen the aerofoil is made such that there is least amount of boundary layer separation. Now, the major reason to develop an aerofoil is to increase the lift force. So we'll learn about what is geometry of an aerofoil and a stalling of an aerofoil. So let us get to geometry of aerofoil, that is aerofoil. So we have to learn how is an aerofoil made. So first we'll consider an aerofoil. So over here, this part, that is the initial part of this aerofoil, if we consider this as the wind velocity, so this part of aerofoil is called as the leading edge, and this part of aerofoil is called as trailing edge. So now over here, the line joining the midpoint of the profile with the trailing edge is called as mean camber line. Above this mean camber line, we can see the upper part over here, upper part of the aerofoil. This is called as upper camber profile. And the bottom part is called as lower camber profile, or it can be profile line also. Now, this entire length of the aerofoil parallel to the direction of the flow is called as C, or it is called as chord of this entire aerofoil, and this distance over here is called as the span of the aerofoil. Now, this aerofoil changes this aerofoil is used when, so depending upon our application, we incline this aerofoil to increase the drag friction or to increase the lift on the entire aerofoil. So this angle is called as angle of attack. So this angle of attack is called as alpha. This part is called as angle of attack. So now, what is exactly angle of attack? So this aerofoil can have an angle of attack 0 if it is just parallel to this mean camber line, or this angle of attack can be positive value if the angle is very small. As we turn this aerofoil, then the angle of attack changes, and accordingly there will be a lift force or the drag force on that entire part. Generally, an aerofoil is used to increase the lift force on an aircraft. So let us study what is stalling of an aircraft. Now, there are two types of aerofoil. This aerofoil which we considered over here, this was a symmetrical aerofoil. There are some aerofoils which are asymmetric. Now, this is an example of an asymmetric aerofoil, where over here, this is an aerofoil where we can see the lower profile, camber profile, is a changes from the upper camber profile. Now, this is used in aircraft aircraft wind, such that if we increase the angle of attack over here, then the lift force over here can be increased. Now, if the lift force over here can be increased, then what happens over here? We can increase the lift force by separating the boundary layer over here. If the boundary layer separates over here, then the pressure, if we consider over here P2 and the pressure we consider over here as P1, so what happens is P1 is greater than P2. Due to this, there will be some lift force on this entire aerofoil. Now, what is a stalling of an aircraft? So we can imagine an aircraft which is taking off and then it goes at a higher altitude and it remains in that position. But it remains in that position, supposingly it is taking off, then it attains a certain altitude, then it travels in the straight direction. But we know that over here the weight of the aircraft is going to act downwards, whereas we have to take the aircraft forward. But to overcome this challenge of the weight of the aircraft, we use concept of stalling of an aircraft. We align the flaps or the wings of the aircraft such that there is maximum lift force produced. That means over here, just opposite to the weight, there will be the lift force. If the lift force of the aircraft becomes equals to the weight of the aircraft, then what happens is there is a stalling of an aircraft. That means the aircraft remains in horizontal position, and whatever the fuel is burnt over here, that is used to take the aircraft from one point to another point in the horizontal direction. So this development of aerofoil is important for stalling. Or else, if we didn't have this aerofoil in an aircraft, what would have happened? We have to spend more energy in lifting the aircraft from point to point, as well as we have to drag the aircraft through the air. So to minimize the lift force over here, we design or we change the angle of attack to a value such that it such that the lift force will becomes equals to the weight. Now during, if the lift force becomes equals to the weight, then there is a stalling of an aircraft. And so this over here, this part over here was a profile which was asymmetric profile. Sometimes there are profile which are symmetric profile. Symmetric profiles are seen in aquatic animals such as fish. We have seen the if we consider a fish, that the shape of the ship fish is also an aerofoil shape. Now over here there is a symmetric profile over here, because first of all the fish doesn't travel at a very high altitude, as well as the velocity with which it travels is also very small. So the amount of drag over there is very small, and we do not need the lift force equals to the drag force. If at all the lift force we had to be equals to the weight, then the angle of attack is changed by the entire animal, and it will make the lift force of the fish equals to the weight, due to which it can float, swim in aquatic conditions. So I hope you have understood what is aerofoil theory, geometry of an aerofoil, as well as stalling of an aerofoil. Thank you.